Hey, Woman Developed, how you doing out there? Thank you so much for watching this video. It is pre-recorded, but nevertheless, it's going to have the same essence because I'm here and the content will help you. I truly believe that. Now, have you ever been put in a position where someone tried to play something upon you, but it just didn't fit you? It wasn't even your style. You just said, no, that's not me. But you didn't necessarily say, no, thank you. You received it or you took it in because you didn't want to be disrespectful, nor did you want to hurt that person's feelings. Well, today I want to help you to say no thank you. And it's okay to say no thank you. All right. So I want to identify just a couple of places, right? You first must know where you are. What fits you? Do you know what fits you? Do you know what your style is? Do you know what your anointing is? Do you know what your purpose in life is? Do you recognize your function? Because if you don't, then what tends to happen is somebody gonna come along with something else and you're not gonna say no thank you. You're gonna take it because you don't want to hurt their feelings. You're going to take it because you don't yet identify what is for you. So you may say, hey, it might be for me, so I'm going to take it. But I want you to first identify where you're at, right? I want you to go with me for a moment in a hotel, a mall, an amusement park. A lot of times when you go to these various places, there may be a directory or something on the wall to let you know you are here, right? And it may be distinguished with a circle or some form of a mark, or an arrow to let you know where you're at in proximity to where you need to go, where you need to be, where are you looking to go. You may say right now, I'm at a place of indecision. I'm at a place where I'm at a fork in the road. I'm at a place where I feel hopeless. I'm at a place where I don't see my dreams. I'm at a place, you know, where I don't know what my ministry is, what my calling is. Why have I been created? Why am I here? I've been there before. Hey, I don't know if you're there at this moment or you yourself have been there or you may enter into that place, but I want to be able to help you to maximize your standard of living, maximizing the potential that you have within you, that it can grow, it can evolve, and it can develop. Because if not, what happens is if you sit in a particular place too long, people are going to come along and say, hey, maybe this is for you. I think this will fit you. I think this is your style. And all the while, you could be saying on the inside, that is not me. I don't even like that. I don't like working with children. I don't like, you know, speaking. I don't like all of the things that someone is putting upon me. But what happens is, again, if you don't know where you're at, what your function is, or where you are going, you would tend to just embrace or take in everything that somebody is bringing to you. I've been there. I've been in a place where people would say, I see you doing this, or I believe that this is for you. And because I was at a place in my life where there was no definition, because I didn't truly know what my purpose was or the genesis of my existence that I can live in and from that point, I was taking everything on. I said, okay, well, maybe this is for me. I was not in a position to say no, thank you. So I was doing everything that someone had brought to me. And even though it was tight, or even though it didn't fit, or one arm was in and one arm wasn't, because the fabric wouldn't stretch all the way around to come upon me and for me to truly embrace it, I walked around looking foolish to myself because it wasn't me. But I like to say that I'm at a place in my life, or in a position in my life, that I say no thank you often. And that's a great place to be, to say no thank you. Because when you don't say no thank you, what you're doing is you're robbing yourself of the true fulfillment of your purpose and your destiny. You're robbing yourself of where you ought to be and how you can truly, you know, impact lives and change lives, and how you can encourage and empower others, and you can inspire others based off of who you are. So who are you? Where are you? As we just used the examples of a hotel, of an amusement park, or of a mall, where are you? Where do you need to be? And when you recognize, you know, that I need to be at a different level, in a different place in my life, you know, I'm here right now. I'm here. I'm stuck. That's my here. I'm here. I'm discouraged. That's my here. I'm hopeless. That's my here. You know, I'm at a place that I don't see my dreams anymore. They don't seem to be living. That's where I'm at right now, at this very moment. But where do you need to be? How can you function now in bringing to life what was once within you? That you can overcome, you know, the whole mindset of, I don't want to offend, that you can overcome the whole mindset of not being able to say no, that you can overcome that whole mindset of saying that you have to accept everything that comes in your direction. Because what tends to happen is if we're not moving, hear me clearly, when you're not moving, what tends to happen is people will place things upon you. And now you become a hoarder of everybody's ideas, everybody's thoughts, everything that somebody placed upon you, you become a hoarder of that. And so therefore you're stuck in a place of not knowing how to move. But when you get to that place and you say, I'm here, but I need to be there, then you're going to say, listen, it's going to cause some sacrifice. It's going to cause a little bit of pain. It's going to cause me being disciplined. It's going to cause me being assertive at times. It's going to cause me saying, no, thank you. So when you recognize that, okay, someone, and intentionally, it may not be to oppress you and to hold you down. The person genuinely can say, you know what, this looks good on you. This fits you. This suits you. And they're giving it out of the goodness of their hearts. They're saying it because they're trying to help you progress and move. They want to help adorn you with something lovely. So it's not necessarily that they're trying to hold you down, but when it doesn't fit, when it doesn't fit with your God-given purpose, or it doesn't fit to lead you into your destiny, then it is something that is holding you up and that can actually hold you back. When you don't recognize where you're at. So where you're at may be in a place, like I said, of despondency. You're discouraged. You're feeling hopeless. You've been at the same level, the same place for a long time. And so many things have been placed upon you. Like I said, people would say, hey, you should do this. And quite frankly, I did it. I'm not doing it now because I realized it wasn't a part of my function. It wasn't a part of the place that God has placed me. I think about where he says that, listen, we are many members, but we are in one body, and he placed us in the body where he saw fit. He gave me a function to what it is that I'm doing that possibly your function may not be. Now, we both be hands, but your function and what you do with your hands may be totally different than what I'm doing. Nobody has the same purpose. We don't have the same skills, abilities, and talents. They may be similar, but they're not identical. The way that God uses you and your personality is certainly something different than the way that he uses me and my personality. The way that he uses me and the gifts and the abilities and the talents. And so God desires for us to be used in our uniqueness. And that's what we do at Women Developed. We help women intentionally. Help women develop in their uniqueness. See, women have been so classified and grouped as being a whole as women that we have not stepped back and look at the individuality of a woman, where the woman has purpose, have power, and has position. But over time, being grouped and being classified, we've lost our self-identity. We've lost, you know, our voice. We've lost, you know, the power and the position that we ought to operate in and from. So we have to live from the place that God has called us into, right? Live in and work from. Being transparent for a moment. And I don't want to say for a moment because I believe that whenever I go live or whenever I live my life in the live, in the now, I'm transparent. Why do I say that? Because I truly believe that we have to lead from the light and not from the darkness. And what I mean by that is I cannot, you know, say something to you or try to share something to you from a dark place and hoping that you enter into the light. Here it is. I am the light at the end of the tunnel. What does that mean? What am I saying when I say I am the light at the end of the tunnel? Meaning God brought me out. God made a way for me. God allowed me to see my now, where I am, and proximity to where I needed to be, and then for me to live that very function that he created within me. I believe that every life on the face of this earth needs to have a personal mission statement. If you have not yet recognized your personal mission statement, get along with yourself. Sometimes it's a little difficult because we're so used to being surrounded by noise, but getting along with yourself, and I can guarantee you, you will begin to recognize and identify what your life's purpose is, what your personal mission statement is. I know my mission is to help individuals, encourage them, empower them, strengthen them. Yes, show compassion and love to help them get from where they're at to where they need to be. Every life needs to be developed. Every life needs to grow. Every life needs to be fulfilled. That's what God calls for us. But there was a point in my life that everything that everybody said mattered to me. And so even when I wanted to step out and do what I know that I was called to do, I always thought about, what is somebody saying? I always thought about, what is somebody going to say if I step out and do this? So that kept me in that position now to begin to hoard what people had put upon me. And you ever seen those shows, those hoarders? It's like, my goodness, can you even walk through this place? There is no pathway for you to even walk from one end to the next. So I was stuck in the midst of everything that I allowed. It's not the person's fault. Sometimes we look at people and say, it's your fault because you sold this idea. It's your fault because you gave me this garment, or you've given me this. But that's not true. I always go back to David, right? In 1 Samuel chapter 17, when he saw Goliath, when he saw this uncircumcised Philistine, as he said, that was coming against the army of the Lord. And King Saul at that time said, here, David, put on my armor to defeat this enemy. But David understood and he knew who he was. He said, hold on, I can't fight or I can't live. I can't accomplish what I need to accomplish in your armor. I have to accomplish what God has called me to do. I know that I have victory. I know that whatever it is that I do, that I am going to succeed at it, but I have to do it in what God has given me. So you have to identify, where are you right now? Where do you need to go? Where is the proximity of your blessing? Where is the proximity of the next venture that God is calling you into? Where is he leading you? What people are he calling you to help? Right? You have to recognize that. What is your function? Your function is not the same as mine. Mine's not the same as yours or the next person. We have to embrace it and be okay. David was all right with his slingshot and those 5 stones that he found by the brook. He was okay with that because it was what was within him to allow him to function and to move in what he needed to do. Same thing within you. When I think of Woman Developed, and you see her, she is a her. You see her on social media. You see her across your screen. You see her with quotes. You see me as a face. I like to say, I am Woman Developed. You are Woman Developed. Woman Developed pretty much is this. We have a fully developed woman on the inside of us. Sometimes we go through things in life and we feel like we're by ourselves. We feel alone. We feel like there is nobody that is there to help us. There is nobody there to offer us encouragement. There is nobody there to offer us with the insight that we need to get to the next level. But I'm here to say, if you spend time with yourself, if you focus on the inward part of yourself, you will see that there is a fully developed woman on the inside of you saying, here I am. I have the joy that you need. I have the hope that you need. I have the patience and the love that you need. I have the forbearance, long suffering. I have what you need. I have the confidence and the boldness that you need. I have the authority and the power that you need. The woman that is within you is unique. The woman that is within you is powerful. The woman that is within you is fully equipped. Recognizing who you are, recognizing your functionality, recognizing for the purpose for which you have been sent, and then you can live from it. You can live in it. You will find yourself being self-sufficient in a sense of being satisfied. Now, I'm not here to say that we are not in need of anyone, but we don't want to be codependent, that I can't move unless you do. I can't say unless you say, that I can't live unless you live. But we have a fully developed woman inside of us saying, listen, I'm powerful. I know that there is purpose. I know that there is position, and I'm going to help you get to it. We are here to intentionally help a woman develop in her uniqueness. Over a course of time, women have been incorporated and grouped and labeled just as women, that we lost our individual function as a woman. We've lost our identity as a woman. We've lost our voice as a woman. You were created woman. You are singular. There is something special and unique about you. So where are you? What is your function? Where do you need to go so that you can live in it? Don't allow people to place upon you something that doesn't fit. Say no, thank you. It's all right. It's okay to say no, thank you. Listen, it's not an intentional thing that you're trying to hurt somebody's feelings, but in the end of the day, if you don't learn how to say no, thank you, you're hurting yourself. If you don't learn how to say no, thank you, you are not allowing your destiny to be fulfilled. If you do not say no, thank you, you will be held captive to a place that you have outgrown. I like to say going to different levels, accelerating and going to the next height. We talked about leveling up, right? In order to level up, it's going to cause for some discipline. It's going to cause for you to get to that place where you have made up your mind to say, I have to move from here. I'm here now, but I need to go up. I'm here now, but I need to go out. So wherever you're at, get to that place of alone time with yourself. Get a mission statement, personal mission statement. That is my challenge to each and every one of you. I want you to get a personal mission statement. Live by that mission statement. That is what fits you. That is what suits you. What your mission statement is. Christ himself had a mission statement as to why he came, right? He came to set the captives free. He came to deliver. He came to set us free, and he fulfilled that mission. Will you fulfill yours? So again, it's all right to say no, thank you, so that you can move to where God has called you to move. It's time to progress. It's time to move forward. No longer can we stay at the place that we have originally set out into. But God said he'll send us to a place. He'll show us a place. We may not be able to see it right now, but trust and believe that the place that he has for you is a blessed place. I love you all. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. Share it with somebody, all right? I love you much and stay